Greetings everyone, today I am going to introduce you the SUPIR Online by the SUPIR original developers. If you had watched my previous tutorials, you will know by now that the SUPIR is the ultimate upscaler that no one can compete with, both in the paid upscalers or in the open source upscalers. From this image to this image is possible with SUPIR. It is just mind-blowing. And now the original authors, the developers of the SUPIR, started an online website where you can use the SUPIR online on cloud without having any GPU. It is currently a paid service, but they contacted me and told me that they are going to use the fund they generated on this service to develop SUPIR version 2 and most awaited SUPIR video. So I have prepared amazing public Patreon article. The link will be in the description of the video. This is a public post. You don't need to be my Patreon member or you don't need to register Patreon. The link of SUPIR Online is here. Just click this link to go to the website. You need to register and also set up some billing. Then you will be able to start using it. For using it, we have workbench here. The link is here. The interface is very simple. You just upload your image, which one you want to upscale. For example, this is the original image that I have used. You set the upscale factor from here. Since this is a very low resolution image, I'm going to first upscale it. Then I'm going to continue upscaling the original upscaled image. There are sampler, lighting, balance, ultimate perception, prioritizing, fidelity, quality. I have tested all of this, but by default settings, it is working pretty good as well. So this image is originally 330 pixel to 277 pixel. Therefore, I have upscaled it to 4x first with ultimate perception, the best quality, and the fidelity option here because I want the best resemblance to the original image. With texture richness 1 and creativity 0. You also need to describe an image description. For image description, I have used the Claude 3.5. It is free on poyer.com. The link is here. Just upload your image and you can use this simple prompt. Caption this image in details. And the Claude will provide you a description for your image. The testing prompts are shown here. So let's copy this. Paste image description here and create. And it will upscale image for you. You don't need a GPU for this. So I already have done huge amount of testing for this creature and this real image. The test results are posted on Hugging Face as a zip file. You can download from here and here. The zip files links are in the post. So what is inside this zip file? Inside this zip file, you will find all the generated images with their configuration. So what does this configuration mean? For example, let's open this image and this image turned that this tiny image into this amazing image. You will notice that there will be some hallucinations like this. You can easily delete them and then you can remove the background. Let's also do this. For example, let's save this like this. Then for removing the background, we also have an amazing new state-of-the-art background remover, BiRefNet. Just click here. So you can download and use this background remover or you can use any background remover as well. Let me start BiRefNet and show you how it is going to remove the background. But this is a very simple background, so you can remove it with any software. Currently, it doesn't support upscaling without any background. So let's remove the background of this image. Let's just drag and drop this. And we just need to do a single image process. It is going to remove the background with maximum best possible quality. But since this is a simple image, you can use a tool to remove background. You can even use the paint.net like this. However, using such state-of-the-art AI model may yield better borders and results. This is also super fast background remover. Since we are first time running it, it is loading the model. Then and also since this image is huge, it is going to take more time than usual. So what is the resolution of this image? This image resolution is 3960 pixels to 3324 pixels, from 330 pixels to 277 pixels. So this is the difference of upscale with SUPIR model. It is just mind-blowing. And the background removed image is generated. So this is how this state-of-the-art model removes the background. If you own Photoshop, you can of course use Photoshop, but this model is able to remove such harder backgrounds as well. Anyway, this is not the case of this tutorial. So I also have image SLIs. Let's go to them. They are also in this post. So this post that I will share on the description is very important. You will find almost all of the options here. So you can compare like the effect of creativity. For example, let's select the ultimate fidelity standard texture 1 and let's select the ultimate fidelity standard texture 1 and creativity 1. With this way, you can compare the effect and impact of each feature on the SUPIR Online website. So this will help you significantly to see the difference of each option. I uploaded both the real image and also this creature image. So you can see the impact of each option on each type of image. For example, let's look at the texture 3 and creativity 3 difference. You can see how much difference it makes. The texture 3 and creativity 3 adds a lot of more details. Of course, there will be some new features like this. So what you can do, you can reduce the creativity and go with higher texture. It will add lesser amount of details, but it will reduce the hallucinations as well. Let's go with the texture 8, for example. Okay, the texture 8 is adding a lot of details, as you can see. This part is not important. You can remove them easily. I didn't remove. So you can see how much details it adds. Let's compare with the original. So the left one was the original beginning image, and the right one is the final image we get. It is just mind-blowing, as you are seeing. This was a 2x upscale. For some images, making 2x upscale may be better, but for this real image, I didn't find it better. For example, I downscaled the original image, then I upscaled it twice. The first upscale yielded this image, then the second time upscale yielded this image. So for this real image, 2x upscale didn't work as expected, but going from original to the 3x upscale yielded the best results. However, for this creature, first I have upscaled it to 4x, like this, from this left original to the 4x upscale, with maximum fidelity being loyal to the original image. Then I used this base image to upscale it 3x more. So you just upload your image, set the description, set the sampler, ultimate is best, set the prioritizing. For such images like creature, the quality works better. Fidelity may work better for real images. Photo type, standard and old photo. When you pick the old photo, if it is not an old photo, it will break the image. Let me show you. So you will see that since this image is not an old photo, it breaks the image like this. So use the standard. Texture richness adds texture details, and creativity adds new features that doesn't exist. So it is pretty simple. Select the ultimate perception, select the fidelity for real images, select the quality for images like this. Use standard photo, add more texture richness for such images like creature or for real images. You may want to reduce. You can also add creativity and make a good description of the image. Then when you go to the history, you will see all of your upscales. You can download them, you can see them. You can download them by clicking the image and click download. So entire history of you will be shown here. The others messaged me, as I said, and they are going to improve the interface, the speed and everything. So if you also want to see a more advanced supermodel like me, give a support to these guys. These guys are amazing. They published it, the super, for free for us. So that is why I have recorded this video as a gratitude of myself to them. Still, if you want to use this amazing model locally, I have a full tutorial. The link is here. Just go to this link. So this is the tutorial, and in the description you will find all of the video chapters. If you want to use this model locally or like on a private cloud service, you can follow this tutorial. However, if you don't want to spend time to set up anything and have better and faster results, you can use the Suppixel AI. This is the official release of the official developers. So I hope you have enjoyed, and pay attention to the image SLI to see every kind of combination and see which option makes which impact. So read this description very carefully, read this page very carefully, and you will know what each option does, and you will find all of the links that you need. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial video.